Now the next exercise is going to be the full sit-up. The one thing that you're going to notice in this demonstration is that Pat has his heels together and his knees out wide. This is mainly because most people, while doing their abdominal exercises, tend to use their hip flexors. Maintaining this position, the butterfly position, will prevent you from using your hip flexors and focus on your abs. You're going to start off with your chest up and your back straight. Make contact with your hands. Bring your hands back up. Keep the chest up as long as you can and bring your back onto the floor one vertebrae at a time. As soon as the hands make contact with the floor, you will then use your abs to lift your chest, keeping your back as straight as possible, look up toward the ceiling, and then make contact with the toes. Common errors to avoid. The main error that you see when it comes to sit-ups is leading with the head and leading with the shoulder, and essentially pulling your upper body forward using momentum from your shoulders and from your neck. This is why people normally have neck pain. The next error that we commonly see is essentially flopping yourself back onto the floor on the way down. So you're not using the negative of the exercise to work your abdominals. The final good example will show that you want to keep your heels together, knees out wide, you want to lead with the chest, try to keep your hands pointed up toward the ceiling, touch the toes, bring the hands back up, and then bring the chest down one vertebrae at a time, really making the abs work. Do this and you can do 10 of these sit-ups and get the same result that you would get from doing 50 crunches.